I don't trust people who make bitter reflections about war, Mrs. Barham. It's always the generals with the bloodiest records who are the first to shout what a hell it is. It's always the war widows who lead the Memorial Day parades.
That was unkind, Charlie, and very rude.
We shall never end wars, Mrs. Barham, by blaming it on ministers and generals or warmongering imperialists or all the other banal bogeys. It's the rest of us who build statues to those generals and name boulevards after those ministers. The rest of us who make heroes of our dead and shrines of our battlefields. We wear our widow's weeds like nuns, Mrs. Barham, and perpetuate war by exalting its sacrifices. My brother died at Anzio.
I didn't know that, Charlie.
Yes, an everyday soldier's death, no special heroism involved. They buried what pieces they found of him. But my mother insists he died a brave death and pretends to be very proud.
You're very hard on your mother. Seems a harmless enough pretense to me.
No, Mrs. Barham. Now, you see, now my other brother can't wait to reach enlistment age. That'll be in September.
Oh, Lord.
Maybe ministers and generals who blunder us into wars, Mrs. Barham. The least the rest of us can do is to resist honoring the institution. What has my mother got for pretending bravery was admirable? She's under constant sedation and terrified she may wake up one morning, find her last son has run off to be brave. I don't think I was rude or unkind before. Do you, Mrs. Barham?
I will not contribute to your wretched little hoax. I will not help you preserve the wonder of war. I want people to know I was a coward. I want them to know the whole shabby story about my heroism.
Charlie, I don't understand you. Do you know what'll happen if you...
I know what'll happen. I'll embarrass my country, dishonor my service, disgrace my admiral, and humiliate my family, and probably get thrown in the brig for a couple of years.
Then why do it?
Because it's the right thing to do.
I can't believe it. Is this the Charlie Madison who once said, God save us from all the people who do the right thing. It's the rest of us who get our backs broken. Are you seriously going to destroy everything that means anything to you, Charlie, in a futile gesture of virtue? And you're going to put yourself in jail, are you?
I don't care what happens to me.
How bloody brave. But you do care what happens to me. At least you said you did. What am I supposed to do whilst you sit around in your prison cell for 5 or 6 years, admiring the glisten of your own martyrdom?
Emily, I want the world to know what a fraud war is.
But war isn't a fraud, Charlie. It's very real. At least that's what you've always tried to tell me, isn't it? That we shall never get rid of war by pretending it's unreal. It's the virtue of war that's the fraud, not war itself. It's the valor and the self-sacrifice and the goodness of war that needs the exposing. And here you are being brave and self-sacrificing, positively clanking with moral fervor. Perpetuating the very things you detest merely to do the right thing. Honestly, Charlie, your conversion to morality is really quite funny. All this time, I've been terrified of becoming Americanized. And you, you silly ass, have turned into a bloody Englishman.
Emily, there's a matter of principle involved here.
A matter of what? Oh, Charlie, didn't you once say, what's a lion doing in a man's house anyway?
Emily, if a man knows the truth, he has to say it.
Is this the Charlie Madison who once said, I'm not equipped to deal with the truth? I let God worry about the truth. I just want to know the momentary fact of things. And your idea of facts, you said...
Were you a home, a country, a world, and a universe in that order.